Thus saith the Lord, Behold, I will raise up against Babylon, and against them that dwell in the midst of them that rise up against me, a destroying wind, and will send unto Babylon fanners that shall fan her, and shall empty her land. For in the day of trouble they shall be against her round about. Against him that bendeth, let the archer bend his bow, and against him that lifteth himself up in his brigandine. And spare ye not her young men, destroy ye utterly all her hosts. Thus the slain shall fall in the land of the Chaldeans, and they that are thrust through in her streets. For Israel hath not been forsaken, nor Judah of his God of the Lord of hosts. Though their land was filled with sin against the Holy One of Israel, flee out of the midst of Babylon, and deliver every man his soul. Be not cut off in her iniquity, for this is the time of the Lord's vengeance. He will render unto her a recompense. Babylon hath been a golden cup in the Lord's hand, that made all the earth drunken. The nations have drunken of her wine, therefore the nations are mad. Babylon is suddenly fallen and destroyed. Howl for her, take balm for her pain, if so be she may be healed. We would have healed Babylon, but she is not healed. Forsake her, and let us go every one into his own country. For her judgment reacheth unto heaven, and is lifted up even to the skies.
I know.
The Lord hath brought forth our righteousness. Come, and let us declare in Zion the work of the Lord our God. Make bright the arrows. Gather the shields. The Lord hath raised up the spirit of the kings of the Medes, for his device is against Babylon, to destroy it, because it is the vengeance of the Lord, the vengeance of his temple. Set up the standard upon the walls of Babylon. Make the watch strong. Set up the watchmen. Prepare the ambushes. For the Lord hath both devised and done that which he spake against the inhabitants of Babylon. O thou that dwellest upon many waters, abundant in treasures, thine end is come, and the measure of thy covetousness.
I want to give all the praises and the honor to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai Bahashem, Ruka Hakwadash, and double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone. Shalom Lavaquayim, that is peace to the elect. I want to go in on this video. Actually, this was a movie I saw called Knowing. And it relates to prophecy. It has a lot of spirituality in it. Although the movie directors and, you know, what they do, they go off. As usual, I mean, what do you expect? Okay. But anyway, it was about a young, you know, little boy and a little girl. Okay. And the girl had some form of prophecy, gift of prophecy. And she was 50 years prior, she was writing down prophecies. And they put it in the, you know, when they put it in the capsule and put it underground. 50 years later, Nicolas Cage, this character, Nicolas Cage, he was the father of this boy here, and they gave the information to the people that pulled the information out the capsule, gave it to him, and he started writing down a bunch of information, and Nicolas Cage was breaking down the mystery, okay? And that's ironic, because a lot of this come from the scriptures, okay? How the prophet saw things and wrote it. And one come to mind, John the Revelator. When you read Revelation, the first chapter, you see, when thou seest, write it, okay? And this young boy here, his name is Caleb, okay? And at the end, he made it to the so-called promised land, but which was a new world. Now the scripture says the earth will abide forever, but they show the earth is being destroyed. And they showed the angels. These are supposed to be aliens, but they was angels and they was guiding them. And these angels, when you see them, they were really pale and they had yellow hair. So everybody knows what how to break that part down. And that wouldn't have been so. Okay. So it was a lot of spirituality in the movie, you know, So anyway, it also showed how fast the place got, the world got destroyed, was that world represents Babylon, okay? Of how fast Babylon will be destroyed. Now, from the time it took him to get in the car and drive through the streets and make it to his parents' house, you have to watch the whole movie. It doesn't say, but it wasn't that long. So you would estimate probably about an hour. And that's what how the Lord said it was going to be. Now, you have a lot of Christians that say, okay, when, you know, they're not worried about it, they're saved. They're saved by Jesus. Okay. Now, when you look in the movie, you would have seen that the boy and the girl are the ones that got saved, because they were supposed to start a new world, so to speak. So they were a very small number of an elect. Okay. So they were elected, and everybody else got destroyed. Okay. So the elect represents them. Okay. As of Joshua and Caleb. Okay. So out of everybody, and I'm sure there was people who were saying they was Christians and they were saved. This is a prime example that in this man's movies, he even understands. Although he thinks he's going to run to underground shelters and flee out of space, but he understands, the Most High still put it in him to understand that all nations and kingdoms fall. Okay. And this is just another example of what's going to happen. So when you are teaching, you can eat what you want. You can eat abominable foods, and the law doesn't exist. You know, well, let's see what the scriptures say. Isaiah 66:17, it says, they that sanctify themselves. And when he looked in the movie, the woman, she was trying to flee to the cave, right? Well, we could get the spirituality out of that. She was trying to flee to the cave. Okay, and it says, and purify themselves in the gardens behind one tree in the midst, eating swine's flesh, and the abomination and the mouse shall be consumed together, saith the Lord. Okay, consumed with what? Consumed with fire. This fire that you see. Now, this is supposed to be the sun getting mad at the earth and shooting out solar flares and killing the, when you're dealing with the earth magnetic force, okay, you have what you call, if an EMP strikes, kills all your electrical components, and the radiation belt, so to speak, that's around the earth, when that is destroyed, then that, you know, the solar, there's no protection from the sun, the solar energy, okay? It says right here, Revelations 18:10, let me go to six. It says, reward her even as she rewarded you, and double unto her according to her works, in the cup which she had filled to her double. Okay, exactly what was done to us has got to come back. Okay, it's double, you know. This man is the only being on the planet that claims he doesn't have to pay for what has been done. Okay? It says, how much she have glorified herself and lived deliciously off the backs of who? You Israelites. Lived deliciously off the backs of you Israelites. Joy in sports. And, you know, the athletics, you know, even to this day, off of your music, off of your sports, you know, and all the selling out that has to take place. It says, so much torment and sorrow give her, for she saith in her heart, I see the queen and no widow, and shall see no sorrow. Therefore shall her plagues come in one day, death and mourning and famine, and she shall be utterly burned with fire, for strong is the Lord God who judged her. So when you look at the movie, you know, you get a lot out of it. You know, it crept up on them. They had no idea. Now, in the events, this the young man Caleb, he was prophesying, and he didn't really understand what he was seeing. You know, and Nicolas Cage, the one his father had to break down all the writings and the things that was being said. Okay, so they were showing all the events, like the 9/11, the Oklahoma City bombing, all the terrorist events, the high amount of catastrophes that killed a lot of people with earthquakes and volcanoes. And then they had it all the way written up to the nuclear, well, the sun burning the earth, which we say nuclear fire. Now, this is relevant because us as prophets, okay, we don't know the day or the hour, but we know and we can see through the spirit that these things that we're seeing that the prophets wrote down is sure to come to pass. Now, when you read, I believe, Matthew, the 24th chapter, it goes into that. Okay, it says, and the kings of the earth who have committed fornication and lived deliciously with her shall bewail her and lament for her. Okay, because they was making money off of Babylon, the Babylon the Great, which you know is this place that we are now. When they shall see the smoke of her burning, standing afar off for the fear of torment, saying, alas, alas, that great city Babylon, the mighty city, for in 1 hour the judgment is come. Okay, is thy judgment come? And the merchants of the earth shall weep and mourn over her, for no man buyeth their merchandise anymore. Right? Because there's not going to be any trades and selling and stocks. Okay. Now, these elites who know about, who understand some of this, they believe that they're in control of it. Okay. They're even saying, well, we're going to take the, we were liquidating America. We're going to take all the stocks out of it. We're going to change everything. We're going to diverse America, and we're going to do all these things. But they don't understand that they speak through Satan and Shaitan, and he the one directs them. But the Lord is the one that's ultimately guiding everything and bringing everything into motion. Okay? They believe that they're going to escape and start a new world. They're trying to explore, okay, other worlds and planets, you know. They claim. They understand that something is very wrong, okay? The merchandise of gold and silver and precious stones and of pearls and of fine linens and purple and silk and scarlet and all thine wood and all manner of vessels of ivory and all manner of most precious wood and brass and iron and marbles. This is your furniture, your cars, okay? Your televisions. Your appliances, you know, and cinnamon and odors and ornaments and frankincense and wine. This is all your sweet smelling colognes and foods and clothes and everything, man. And your wine, your drinks, and oil and fine flour and wheat and beast and sheep and horses and chariots and slaves, and souls of men, and thy fruits that thy soul lusted after are departed from thee, and all things which were dainty and goodly and are departed from thee, and thou shalt find them no more at all. The merchants of the kings which were made rich by her shall stand afar off for the fear of her torment, weeping and wailing. And why is that? Because they know that the world as they know it has changed. When Babylon is destroyed, the world that they know is going to change, okay? The merchants of these things which were made rich by her shall stand afar off for a fear of torments, weeping and wailing, and saying, alas, alas, that great city was clothed in fine linen, purple and scarlet, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls. Now, you'll have a lot of groups, even some Israelites now, are saying, because you see decked with purple and gold and all that, that's talking about the Vatican. So let's go to Revelation 17. And I think I'm going to start at Revelation 17. And we're going to probably go to verse 5 first. And we're going to prove that that is not talking about, this is not talking about the Vatican City. Revelation 17 and 5. And upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth. Okay. So let's go down to 15. It says, and he saith unto me, thus, I mean, it says, Salaki, it says, the waters which thou sawest where the whore sitteth are peoples and multitudes and nations and tongues. Okay? You don't see this at the Vatican. A water where the whore sitteth with people, multitudes, and nations and tongues. Yes, you will have some people there who may speak some different tongues or even different nationalities. But on a high level on this planet, there's only one landmass that have that much, that fits that prophecy to that level. Because number one, slaves was born here. Number two, you had what you so-called immigrants. Okay. And number three, you had Esau who came. And now you have every nation on the planet flocking to America. Everybody says America is great. That's why Trump is trying to make it great again by doing what he did to make it great the first time. Okay? It's just that simple. We're going to go on to further prove that this is not talking about Vatican City back in the scriptures. This is verse 15, Revelation 18 and 15. The merchants of these things which were made rich by her shall stand afar off for the fear of torment, weeping and wailing, and saying, alas, alas, the great city that was clothed with fine linen and purple and scarlet, decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, for in 1 hour the great riches is come to naught, and every shipmaster and all the company in ships and sailors and as many as trade by sea stood far off. Okay? So that's not talking about the Vatican, okay? And cried when they saw the smoke of her burning, saying, so if it's the Vatican, what the heck is supposed to happen to America? Okay? And cried when they saw the smoke of her burning, what city is like unto this great city? And that cast dust on their heads and cried, weeping and wailing. Okay? So what city is that great that'll cause people to basically lose their damn minds, okay? Alas, alas, that great city wherein were made rich all that had ships in the sea by reason of her costliness, for in 1 hour she is made desolation. That's pretty much all I have on that. That's what's got to happen to Babylon the Great, the daughter of Babylon, okay? That's what's got to happen to the daughter of Babylon. Death, destruction. Okay, in 1 hour. Okay, that's all I have. That's all I have on that. Shalom.